Read and follow all labels and the owner's manual carefully before installing or operating your machine.
Hi, I'm Brent Williams with Miller Electric. We're going to review the basic setup and controls of the Dynasty and Maxstar welders. After a brief explanation, you'll see these machines are easy to set up and offer you the precision and flexibility to improve your weld quality and productivity. Maxstars are DC only and recommended for steel, stainless steel, nickel, titanium, and copper alloys. Dynasties have AC and DC output, which means they're capable of welding virtually all metals, including aluminum and magnesium. The control panels for both of these machines are very similar. Let's take a look. Each is laid out in a left-to-right fashion, just like reading a book. The first column on the Dynasty is polarity. Select AC for welding aluminum or magnesium, and DC for all other metals. Because Maxstars are DC only, this selection is not available on those models. Next is the process column. Use TIG HF impulse if you want to use high frequency to start the arc. This allows you to start the arc without touching the tungsten to the metal. Simply hold the electrode a short distance away and use your remote to trigger the high frequency, which jumps the gap. With both of these machines, high frequency starts the arc and then turns off. Continuous high frequency is not required to stabilize the arc with these advanced inverter power sources. Select TIG lift arc if you want to start the arc by touching the electrode to the metal. This can be used with or without a remote and is helpful when high frequency is not permitted. Select stick mode for AC or DC stick welding. When using a Maxstar, you'll need to connect the stick electrode holder to the positive terminal and the work clamp to the negative terminal. Next is the remote setting. Use remote standard when using a foot or fingertip remote with amperage control. Select remote 2T hold to engage panel amperage or when using a push button style remote. Use the on position for stick and lift arc TIG welding without a remote control. Next, we'll take a look at the pulsar control. We're going to discuss the benefits of pulse TIG welding and how to set it for the results you're looking for. Let's take a close look at pulse TIG welding and how it can improve your weld puddle control. The pulse feature is available on various models. Maxstar and Dynasty welders provide the greatest adjustment, so we'll concentrate on these machines. Before we get into the settings for pulse TIG, let's take a look at what it actually does. Basically, pulsing switches the amperage between a high and a low setting at a given rate. It's that simple. There are many benefits related to using pulse TIG, and one word describes them all: control. Pulsing lowers the average amperage, which helps control penetration and distortion. It also makes welding out of position easier. Pulsing at very high rates can focus the arc for faster travel speeds and increase directional control. There are three things to set when using the pulser: pulse frequency, or pulses per second, peak time, and background amperage. These adjustments are selected using the pulser button on the front panel of the Maxstar Dynasty. First, set the pulses per second, which controls how fast the amperage switches. If you're trying to make a distinct ripple pattern or time the addition of filler to the puddle, turn the pulses per second down below 10. If you're trying to narrow the arc or increase the travel speed, use a higher setting. Turn the pulses per second up to 100, 200, or even higher. Next, you need to set the peak time, which is how long the amperage is at the higher level. This is set as a percentage of time. Common settings are from 40 to 60%. Higher settings give you a wider puddle and more penetration. Finally, set the background amperage, or the low pulse setting. This is set as a percentage of your main amperage. Common settings are from 25 to 50%. For a more fluid puddle, turn it up. The optimum setting depends on what you're trying to accomplish and may take some fine tuning. I hope you find this information useful and encourage you to try pulse TIG welding for your application. We're going to discuss the Weld Sequencer function found on Dynasty and Maxstar products. Specifically, we'll take a look at how to set the Weld Sequencer, some benefits of using it, and applications where you might apply it. Let's take a close look at how to set and adjust the Weld Sequencer function. When TIG welding, it's common to use a remote control to start and stop the weld. Foot controls and fingertip controls can also vary the welding amperage. The ability to make these adjustments on the fly adds to the precision and control benefits of the process. However, not all applications are suitable for using these type of remotes. When you're welding out of position, making repetitious or automated welds, it may be more convenient to preset the entire weld sequence using the panel settings and use a remote to start and stop the weld. There are four parameters to set when using the Weld Sequencer. To begin, select the Remote 2T Hold function in the output column. Set the welding amperage according to your application. Usually, this is based on material thickness. Then, use the Sequencer button to toggle through the available settings. You'll set each value using the main control knob. To begin, set the initial amperage. This is where the machine will start and should be set to an amperage that gives you consistent starts based on your tungsten size without damaging the base metal you'll be welding on. Next, set the initial slope time, or the amount of time it takes in seconds to ramp from the start amperage to the welding amperage. Now, set the final slope, which controls the amount of time it takes in seconds to ramp from the welding amperage to the final amperage. This is commonly referred to as downslope or crater time. Set the final amperage at a level that allows the puddle to shrink and solidify before it turns off. This prevents a large crater from forming at the end of the weld. Now, you're ready to weld. Start the arc using your remote. The sequencer will start and slope to your welding amperage based on what you've preset. As you approach the end of the weld, press your remote to begin the final slope sequence. When the final amperage is reached, the arc will shut off. Next is the gas dig selection, where you'll be able to set your pre-flow and post-flow for TIG welding and adjust your dig setting for stick welding. Pre-flow is the length of time the shielding gas will flow prior to the arc starting. 0.2 seconds should be enough for most applications. Post-flow is the length of time the gas continues to flow after the weld is complete. This protects the weld and your tungsten until they cool sufficiently. The auto post-flow setting automatically adjusts your post-flow time according to your welding amperage, so you always have the right amount. If your application calls for a specific post-flow setting, you can manually adjust the post-flow time in seconds. Dig is used for stick welding and prevents the electrode from sticking to the workpiece. For most electrodes, a dig setting of 30% is sufficient. However, if you're doing an open root weld with 6010 or 6011, or you have trouble sticking the rod, use a higher setting. That concludes the adjustments for the Maxstar, but Dynasties have one more very important function, AC wave shape. All Dynasty products have AC balance and AC frequency control. The feature helps maintain a point in the tungsten, reduce cleaning action, and increase penetration for faster travel speed. We're going to discuss the benefits of using AC balance control for welding aluminum, so you can set and adjust this useful feature for optimum results. Let's take a closer look at AC balance control. AC is preferred for most aluminum applications because it provides cleaning action that helps to remove surface oxides. Let's start with a little background information. All metals form oxides. On steel, it's known as rust, and we know it's there because you can see it. Other metals, like aluminum, form an invisible oxide layer. What's special about aluminum is that the surface oxides melt at a higher temperature than the base metal. It's critical to remove the oxides because they cause welding problems. AC produces cleaning action that helps to remove the surface oxides, and AC balance controls the amount of cleaning action based on how heavy the oxide layer is. A few pointers will take the mystery out of this useful feature and help you get the most out of your Miller Dynasty. To set AC balance, make sure the machine is in AC and push the wave shape button to select balance control. Then, turn the control knob to set the balance percentage. To begin, look at the condition of the aluminum that you'll be welding. Whether it's new and shiny or has a dull gray appearance will be your first indication of where to set the balance control. A balance setting of 75% on a Dynasty is a good starting point for most applications. However, if the material has been in service for some time or it's been exposed to the elements, oxides are likely to be heavier than with newer material. If that's the case, you may want to begin with a slightly lower setting, say 65 to 70%, which gives you more cleaning action. Over time, experience will guide your judgment on where to begin. And remember, a slight adjustment may be all you need. Once you begin welding, you'll need to look for a few indications that you have the proper setting. When you strike an arc, look at the surface appearance of the puddle. It should be shiny and clean without a heavy film or any particles floating on the surface. If you see dark spots in the puddle, adjust the AC balance down because you need a little more cleaning action. If the puddle appears shiny and clean, but you have a wide etching zone around the weld, turn your balance up because you have too much cleaning action. Another result of having the balance set too low is tungsten balling. What this means is your tungsten will melt back and not stay sharp. When you have the AC balance adjusted correctly, you'll see a bright, shiny puddle without anything floating on the surface. You'll also be able to maintain a pointed tungsten. Now, we've covered the basic guidelines for setting your balance control. You'll probably find that the optimum setting is in the neighborhood of 65 to 75%. Don't be concerned about this. You'll likely find a sweet spot that works well for most applications and requires very little adjustment. The range of adjustment provides flexibility for advanced applications in extreme conditions. I hope this information about AC balance control helps you get the results you're looking for. We're going to discuss the benefits of using AC frequency control for welding aluminum with the Miller Dynasty and how to set this useful feature for optimum results. Let's take a close look at AC frequency control. Think of AC frequency control as arc focus. Most often, joint design influences where to set your AC frequency, although many people find a setting they prefer because it works well for them. Lower AC frequencies provide a soft, wide arc. Some people prefer this, while others find it easier to accomplish certain tasks. If you're welding an outside corner or butt joint, a lower AC frequency could produce better results by feathering out the arc to catch both sides of the joint. The problem with low AC frequency settings is arc wander. For example, with a traditional setting of 60 Hz, the arc can wander from side to side, and it lacks the directional control you need for an inside corner weld. The higher the AC frequency, the narrower the arc cone, and the more directional control you'll have, which makes it easier to get into tight places, such as inside corners. This improved directional control also makes it easier to weld thick to thin materials, and you'll probably notice that higher AC frequency settings give you a more smooth and stable arc. A good starting point is 120 Hz for most applications. But understanding the effects of AC frequency will allow you to adjust the settings and tailor the arc for your application. We've now covered the basic setup for Maxstar and Dynasty welders, so you have the information to get the most out of your machine. If you have additional questions, make sure to visit millerwelds.com and click on the Resources tab. Thanks for watching.